The triangle choke is one of my favorite techniques, and equally important to the mechanics of performing the choke properly are the setups. As with any submission, the setup is equally important to the actual submission itself. So in this case, we're going to use a little bit of push and pull. So if I try to just push my arm into TJ, he's going to resist that. So what I want to do is instead pull, he pulls back, and then I use that to push his wrist back into his chest. So I'm here, I do a little push-pull, I'm pulling, he pulls back, I push that into his chest, foot on the hip, I'm gonna bring my leg over the shoulder, I beat his elbow, I beat his hand. Now, my shin is going perpendicular to his neck, I'm able to cross my legs. I want my knee over my ankle here, pass the arm over, squeeze my knees together, pull down on his head, and lift with my hips. So we do a little bit of push-pull. I pull, he pulls back, bam. Very important to put the foot on the hip. Now I can elevate my hips and swivel if I need to because I'm driving off of his hip. Now I cross my legs. Be sure to lock it behind the knee. If we're just like this, he will be able to break it. So sometimes you have to grab your shin, kick into position, lock it up. Now, pass that arm over, pull down on the head, lift with the hips. One of the classic setups for the triangle is arm lock, triangle, arm lock. So what we want to do is attack for the arm. He's going to resist by pulling his arm out, and that sets us up perfectly for the triangle, and we'll have a chance to analyze some of the mechanics a little more in depth. So hold on to his sleeve here, put the foot on the hip, dive my arm underneath his hamstring. I pull myself into position, go for the arm lock. He pulls out. Immediately, my hand goes to the tricep here. I throw my leg to the other side of his head. Now I use the inside of my thighs to transition to where I'm square again. But I need to go even further. I need to get perpendicular to my opponent. So I grab my shin, find that hip again, continue my rotation. Now I hold this, kick up, lock behind the knee, turn my knee in. Now there's a little bit of space here because his arm is on this side of my body. Ideally, it should be on the other side. So I lift, pull that arm over, and now I'm in a very tight position. So again, squeeze the knees together, lift my hip, pull down on the head. We're tightening the noose from all angles. So here. Going for the arm lock. He pulls out immediately, hand to the tricep, knee on the other side. I use the inside of my thighs to pivot. Grab my shin. It's not going to be enough. It's very common for guys to try to get the triangle from here, but note that the back of my calf is running over his back. We need it to cut 90 degrees to his neck. So if I need to, if I have it here, I can raise my hips, pass that arm over, then readjust, grab my shin, continually adjusting that angle, cross, lock behind the knee, and then we're here. There is a trinity of sorts. If you don't quite have the triangle, but you have this leg positioning, what you need to do is always adjust the arm, the head, and your hips. So up, over, grab your shin, adjust here, pull on the head. No, that's not quite right. Grab your shin again, adjust yourself here, pull on the head. Yes. So incrementally, we can end up in the triangle. So an example of that would be as follows. Here, I come around. Oh, this is it. I lift my hips. I pass this over. I'm pulling on the head. He's going to be trying to posture up. I pull on the head. Now I can grab my shin. Boom. Slide this out. Lift up. Lock behind. Knees together. And then lift. The arm lock and the triangle are closely related, both from the guard position and the mount position. So I like to often treat this combination as an arm lock, triangle, arm lock, and not just simply an arm lock, triangle. You'll see what I mean. I come into position, boom, he pulls that out. I'm coming around, and now he stands up. This is a perfect time to hook under his heel, use that to pivot as I come into position here, throwing the leg over the face.